Hey there, Toons! Zucchini Jr. here with another video. So recently, Aura came to me talking to me about Toontown House, which is a game basically my father has played on, and talking about how it just recently went into an open beta, he thought it was a pretty cool game, and he asked me to check it out. Of course, I have never played it, I didn't know they went into open beta until today, and Aura had an account and I didn't, so... yeah, and of course he's allowed me to go on his Toontown account and make one, so let's go on Toontown House and see how it is. So my recording software decided not to record my voice, so instead of getting live commentary, you're gonna be getting unlive commentary. So basically what I did is, I made my character, I made him look as cool as possible, we got to the name changer, and whoa, you can't type in your own name. I have a feeling they do that because they don't got technically a support staff that can go in and approve names and make sure that people ain't going around with like profanity names like curse words or anything like that, which I can totally understand. Then it came up with the option allowing me to pick where I start. I can either pick in Toontown Central, in Donald's Dream, not Donald's Dreamland, Donald's Dock, or Daisy's Garden, each with different stats, which was pretty cool. You could even go up to level 4 gag tracks, and three of those will be at level 4, and one of them will be at level 3, which I found to be very cool. Which, because Toontown Rewritten Infinite, or the original Toontown, never implemented that, and I have a feeling that's going to be pretty handy. I got my tasks as soon as I spawned in the world just by going to the HQ. I got two of them, and then I went home, checked my catalog, checked out my house. It was pretty cool, rearranged my house a bit, and then I went to Toontown Central because I could no longer teleport to Daisy's Garden because I left Daisy's Garden for some reason, and yeah, that was pretty much it, and then I said goodbye with my toon. So, anyway, Toontown House, overall, I give it a 6 out of 10, and the only reason it's not, like, a 9 out of 10 is because of all the bugs and missing content, but other than that, it's pretty awesome. Toontown Rewritten and Infinite, I give, like, an 8 out of 10, so it's not far behind, it just got to get a little more done by fixing the resolution, allowing you to have more resolutions to pick from so you can straighten it to your screen, allowing you to type a name, but overall it's just awesome and I really enjoy it. And if y'all guys want to see more videos of Toontown House, I'm pretty sure Aura will be doing it, but if y'all want to make sure he does it, then you can comment in the comments, I guess, and ask him to do it. And yeah, so anyway guys, that's all my time, and I'll see you later, Toons. Bye.